When it comes to moons in our solar system, Earth's companions, like our moon itself, are a familiar sight. However, if we look at two of our neighboring planets, Venus and Mercury, we notice an unusual absence. They both lack moons. This lack of natural satellites has perplexed scientists for years, spurring the investigation of different possibilities to solve the question of why Venus and Mercury are moonless. Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you like the video, please like, share, and subscribe. Mercury is the solar system's smallest planet in terms of both size and mass. Mercury's small size means that it does not have a strong gravitational field, making it difficult for it to hold anything in orbit. Furthermore, Mercury's proximity to the Sun would make it impossible for any moons to maintain an orbit around Mercury. The Sun's gravitational attraction is too strong, and any moons that developed around Mercury would be soon drawn away by its gravity. Why Venus is moonless is more complicated to explain than Mercury, since Venus is far larger. At 80% of the mass of the Earth, Venus's gravitational field would be more than strong enough to hold onto any moons. However, Venus is still significantly closer to the Sun than Earth, and the gravitational pull of the Sun would make it difficult for any moons to remain in orbit. However, it is still possible for Venus to hold on to one or more moons. It is generally accepted that Venus did have a moon at one point in its history. Venus, like Earth, had seen some disastrous collisions with other planets. Scientists believe Venus had two planetary collisions. The initial collision caused the development of a moon in orbit around Venus. The second planet collided with Venus, causing it to rotate in the opposite direction. It may not seem noteworthy that Venus began to turn in the opposite direction, but the rotation had a tremendous impact on its moon. During its original orientation, Venus progressively transferred some of its rotational energy to its moon, causing it to drift away gradually. However, if a planet rotates in the opposite direction as its moon's orbit, it no longer transmits energy to the moon. Instead, the planet absorbs its moon's orbital energy, forcing it to progressively sink towards the planet. Once the moon is close enough, the planet's gravitational pull rips it apart, bringing the debris hurtling down. Scientists believe this is what happened to Venus billions of years ago, which is why it no longer has any moons. That's it for today's video. Stay safe and healthy.